A very good evening to all of you and welcome back to our channel, The Teacher. This is Rajiv and today in this tutorial, I will show you that how you can create this parallax zoom-in effect in PowerPoint 2016 or 2019. Even you can create this animation in earlier versions as well. So this is the first technique where the foreground picture is growing and the background picture is shrinking. And that way it is creating the parallax zoom-in effect. And the foreground picture is a transparent picture. The boy standing on the hills is a transparent picture. That is why you are also seeing the background picture in its full size. So you see a glitch in this technique when it make a loop, then you also see a glitch between the loop. So to avoid this loop, I have used a second technique and the same effect has been accomplished by refining it. And you will no longer see a glitch between the loops. But there is another problem in this effect. If you see here, right here, then after a loop, the position of the images changes a little bit. Let's take another look. And you will see these hills move a little bit. And to correct this error, we are using the third technique, and in this third technique we are using the morph transition, and that way it is will create a perfect zoom in parallax effect. So I also used action button on it. To go to the next slide, you need to click on this toggle text, and that way it will start showing you the parallax effect, and clicking on this text again will zoom out. And there is no difference between the position of the images and making it a perfect animation. So let's get started with the first presentation. And we are using three different images for that. First, we have this Y foreground. And as you can see that the rest of the picture area is transparent and you can see the white background of the slide. So after inserting the hills background, you have to send this picture to the back by clicking on the send backward drop down button and you send to back. And it is also showing you the order of the images in the selection pane as well. The boy foreground picture is on top of all other two pictures and hills background is on number 2 and hills blur background is on number 3. So we replicated the hills background image and then we use the blur command on it. By selecting it and go to picture format, click artistic effects, and here you can choose the blur command. So once you have these three images on your slide, what you need to do, you need to apply the animations effect, and here you can see the list of animations that I have applied on this presentation. So basically we are using two different slides. On the first slide, the boy foreground picture will grow and the hills background picture will shrink. To grow the boy foreground picture, we are using grow shrink emphasis effect with 200% growth rate. And the duration of this animation is 5 seconds. And we are also applying the smooth hand up to 5 seconds. So that way it will start growing in and will end very smoothly. Hit the OK key. And for the hills background, we are shrinking the hills background to 75%. So growing the foreground picture and shrinking the background picture will create the parallax zoom in effect. Hit the OK key. So what I want this hills background picture to fade out slowly and the hills blur background to appear or fade in slowly. And doing these two animations simultaneously will create this effect where the hills background picture will start getting blur. And then it will get completely blurred in the end. So once you have your first slide ready, what you can do, you can make a duplicate of this slide. And on the second slide, we need to reverse this animation. We need to shrink the boy foreground picture. And then we need to grow the hills background picture. So we need to reverse the animation. But when without animations, if you will see the slideshow of the second slide, then it will show you the images in their exact size. But on the first slide, in the end, we have the Y foreground picture 200% zoomed and hills blur background 75% shrinked in the end. So we need the same sizes on the second slide. So what I did, I first applied the same growth and shrink rate on these three pictures with a duration timing of 0.01 seconds. So that way, when you will move to the second slide, it will immediately increase and decrease the size of these images within 0.01 second, and that is why you see a glitch between the slides. On the second slide, I also changed the position of Hill's blur background to second and Hill's background to number 3, because we want this Hill's blur background to start fading out slowly to make the reverse animation again. So what you can see here, we are applying the fade out effect on the Hill's blur with a 2.50 second duration and a delay timing of 1 second. And at the same time, we are also applying the shrink effect with 133%, not 125%. At this picture, we have shrink this picture 25% in the previous slide. On the next slide, you have to adjust the size, and that will be 133%, because the original size of the image was 11.62 inches and we reduce it to 25% on the first slide and it become 8.71. But on the second slide, we again need to change the size to 11.62. But if you will add 8.71, but if you will add 25% growth rate to 8.7 inches, then it will become 10.8875. So we need 11.62. So what we can do in Excel, select this formula and go to data. What if analyst goal C, I want the C1 value exactly to be 11.62 by changing the value of B1. Hit the OK key and it says you need to adjust the size 33%. So on the second slide, we are increasing the size to 133% and doing this for the Hill's background as well. This is fading in and this is fading out, and Y foreground picture is adjusting to 50%, because on the first slide we have doubled the size 200%, and on the second slide in the beginning it again gets 200% within 0.01 second. And then it start reducing its size to 50%. In the second presentation, what I did, I adjusted the size on the second slide. So as on the first slide, we are growing the Y foreground picture to 200%. So if you check the size of this picture, then it is 8.6. And on the second slide, what I did, I changed the size and make it double to 7.2, and as log aspect ratio is selected, when you will change the height, it will automatically adjust width accordingly, and then you need to align the picture to the center and the middle of the slide. And I did the same for rest of these two pictures. If you go to the first slide and open the selection pane, and here I select the Hill's background, and if you note down the size of this picture, then it is 11.62. And on the second slide, what I did, I changed the size to 8.71 by deducting 25% from it. So that way you don't need to apply these three animations in the beginning, because we have adjusted the size of the images itself. So let's see the slideshow. The only difference will be in the position of the images. When the second loop will happen, you can see a little bit shift in the position of this hill image right here. And that is because we need a value up to 3 decimal places, but PowerPoint does not allow that. So you have to stick with 8.71 instead of 8.715. Now let's see the third presentation, and using the morph transition, it is very easy to create parallax zoom in effect in PowerPoint 2016, 2019 or Office 365. So in this third presentation, we also want user to interact with our presentation. So we type this text and insert an action on it. I want PowerPoint to move to the next slide when someone click on this text. So for that, I use mouse click hyperlink to slide 2. And on slide 2, on the same text, we are applying different action. I want user to move to the third slide when he click on this text. And on the third slide, we are applying an action back to the second slide. So it will make a complete loop between these three slides. And if you want to continue the loop, you can also go to the slideshow, click setup slideshow, and make a check mark on loop continuously until escape. So on these two slides, second and third slides, you need to apply the morph transition. Go to the transition tab, click the morph transition for the second and the third slide, and change the duration as you want. So let's see the slideshow, and here we have the parallax zoom in effect with the action buttons. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing, and commenting on this video. And do subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful evening.